Hey Aquarius, we are just going to let this message just pour right out. It's a message from Spirit. What's going on with Aquarius? I think what we have here is someone who loves you very much, very much. And I feel, however, that this person feels like they've missed the boat, or there was some kind of a crucial choice point that they missed. Just going to adjust the lighting. And I think they're rather horrified that they've missed it. I'm getting the feeling that someone just wants to get back to where they were. I feel like the timing is off somehow. That there was a time when, you know, you loved them, they know that you loved them. But what's happened is because they stayed in this energy for too long, you had to make a choice probably to exit the connection. And now they are here where you were, and they know that you're not there. And now they are horrified, they're panicked, and they want to get it back. They want to hunt you down. This person may have treated you badly. I'm thinking of that, there's an REM song that I was listening to earlier today. It's a part of the song where the person says, "I tripped and fell, did I fail?" And then they realize that what they put their person through, they feel so bad that they want to feel it too. It's something like what I wanted you to feel. I want to feel it now. I need a chance, a second chance. You know. Okay, so what else is this person saying? What else is this person saying to Aqua? Yeah. So they probably felt very at home in your presence. They might have felt very comforted in your presence. They probably enjoyed the way that you kept your surroundings, however your home was, your apartment, or wherever you saw each other. And they're missing that, and they're trying to figure out, how do I get this back? I'm just hearing this, I need a second chance. I need a second chance. And they're trying to figure out, how do I swing this with Aqua? How do I swing this? So at this point, I don't think that you're in contact with this person and they're thinking deeply about you. That's Jupiter in Libra. This person is praying, literally praying for a little blessing up there. They're hoping and praying that for a second chance. And I feel like they don't want anyone else. They don't want anyone else. They want back. They want this back. They want the control back as well. That's the Four of Pentacles, that's Sun in Capricorn. This is the person who wants to control everything, including turning back time. Just look at how he's holding that pentacle like a ship's wheel. trying to control the course of destiny. What else do we have? Yeah. I don't know why I felt like putting the cards down like that. Look at them looking at time, at what's behind them, what's before them. I feel like they're looking at this. They're actually looking at this. Looking at this very closely. And I think they're looking at how they turned. They're hoping, they're wishing they could, that serpent is wishing they could turn back time. They wish they could pull that wheel back, roll it back. And I can't help but notice there is a star in that lantern. How do I get back to the star? How do I get the star back? So you might have shut them out. You're in that lantern now. How do they get back into the lantern? They feel like a fool. It's interesting because the song that I mentioned ago, there's a part of that song where he says, the fool might be my middle name. And I'm going to do whatever it takes to bring you up, call you down, sign your name. There's something about secret love in that song, so maybe they kept you a secret, you know, and they're regretting that. What else do we have? What else from this person? Yeah, they really destroyed this. You know, that is the Ten of Swords. That is, believe it or not, Sun in Gemini. There is a Sun rising in this card. And there is a hand gesture in this card that says it's not over. They say that this hand gesture of the man who is down on the ground right there. Sorry about the lighting, Aqua. They say that that hand gesture is the same as the gesture of the Hierophant, which says, this is not what it looks like. All is not what it appears to be. And they're hoping that it's not over. It's not over. And they want to get up and take some action. Perhaps in the past, this person was too active, you know, and cheated on you. Could be a Sagittarius as well. This is a card of Sagittarius. This person may have evolved, you know, from when you last dealt with them. Notice the salamander, its tail is now touching its mouth. This person may now be evolved, but it could be too late. It could be too late. What else do we have? We have from this person. Yeah. I feel like they're looking at you now, and I think that you're stable. You are now in control. You are now stable and in control, and they're wondering how on earth, you know, the way that they used to approach you is they would perhaps throw off your stability. They can't do it anymore. It can't do it anymore. What else do we have? Yeah. This connection was probably stopped by karma. The Justice card often shows up when something is not just, you know. This person, it could be an earth sign as well. This person now could be stable. and they feel that, you know, now I'm stable now. You know, I'm willing to offer all this stability to Aqua. It's not fair, you know, that I can't manifest this now because now I'm ready. What else do we have from this person? I think we're hitting the proverbial brick wall here. This person just wants the Ten of Cups with you now. You know, it's all they can look at. It's all they can think about. And you may have it now with somebody else. This person wants a second chance. You know, I think there's actually a part of that song. I think I'm going to try to find it and put it at the end of this reading. They say, you know, with love comes strange currencies. And here is my appeal. I need a chance, a second chance, a third chance, a fourth chance, a word, a signal, a nod, just to fool myself, to make it real. This person, I think they know this is a stage card, that they're fooling themselves, that they can have this with you because they, no pun intended, fooled up so badly in the past. We'll get one more split and see if we can get sort of a prologue on this. Yeah, I believe that they're looking back with a great deal of melancholy. They're looking at what perhaps they could have had if they had just had some staying power and waited. And now all they can do is look, you know, at the fact that what they had, what they could have had, if they had appreciated and been present in the moment, was true spiritual love. Thanks so much for watching, Aqua.